So dear students, we were solving the problem. This circuit is given to us and it is in steady state. E1 equal to E0, E2 equal to 2E0 and so on. These values are given. Each capacitor has capacitance C0. The circuit is in steady state and we need to find total electrostatic energy stored in the capacitors. Dear students, we very well know that when a capacitor is fully charged in a circuit, then the capacitor blocks electric current in its branch. So, for example, this capacitor blocks electric current in its branch. This capacitor C3 blocks current in its branch. C1 blocks current in its branch. C2 blocks current in its branch. See, when no current is allowed to flow here, then how can there be a current in this branch? Because, for example, if 1 ampere current comes here, then it has to go somewhere. These two branches cannot allow any flow of current. So, there cannot be any current here. No current here. Therefore, absolutely similarly, there cannot be any current in this branch. Because if any current goes here, it has to go either here or here. So, these two capacitors will not allow. Therefore, no current where? 1, 2, 3. No current here. Similarly, no current here, no current here, no current here. Then, where will be current? See, now we can see, current will be flowing like this. Like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, and like this. So, this is the loop in which current will be flowing. And how much current will be flowing? See, in this loop, batteries are E4 and E1 and net will be E4 minus E1. So E4 minus E1 divided by total resistance R, R, R and R. So 4R. E4 minus E1 upon 4R will be the current circulating in this loop. So dear students, for you, I have drawn this circuit like this. I have utilized blue color as well so that this loop should appear clearly. And dear students, you must have got this result. This is the final result. 13 by 8 C0 E0 square. But we are going to go in detail how it is coming and so on. See, this is the blue colored loop in which current is circulating in steady state. Dear students, you very well know that for voltage analysis in any circuit, we can consider any one point at zero potential. So let us take this point, the point F, at zero potential. If it is at 0 volt, then what will be potential here? Plus E4. Because when we are moving on this wire, when we jump this battery, we are going from negative terminal to positive. So plus E4. This is the potential here at this point. Similarly, when we move on this wire, then there is a drop of IR. So this value plus E4 minus IR will be this voltage, this potential at this point, at point H. Similarly, let us move on this wire now. So there is a drop of IR. So this voltage E4 minus IR minus IR will become E4 minus 2IR. Once we have this voltage, let us move on this wire. When we move on this wire, we jump the battery in this way from positive terminal to negative terminal. So there is a drop of E1. So this value minus E1 is this voltage, potential at point A. Similarly, when we move on this wire, drop of IR. So this value minus IR becomes this value. And similarly, we come here at zero, right? We can make this value minus IR, which will be equal to zero. So E4 minus E1 minus 3IR minus IR is equal to 0 becomes the equation of KVL. Or we can write the KVL in very simple way. E4 minus E1 is equal to 4IR. Right? So first of all, current E4 minus E1 upon 4R. See, I is what? E4 minus E1 upon 4R. Right? This is the current. So 3E0 upon 4R, this is the current. So if we need the value for IR, what is IR? It is 3E0 by 4. Got it? We have the value for I, we have the value for IR. Now, we need to write half CV square for each capacitor. So, see, we have got potential for all the points. We need potential for this point. So, this value E4 minus IR, and if we go in this direction, then minus E3. So, this value minus E3 is potential at this point E. Similarly, for this point C, we know this voltage E4 minus E1 minus 3 IR. If we go in this direction, then plus E2. So, this value plus E2 becomes this value. Right? You are getting this value plus E2 is this value. So, now we know potential at each terminal, at each point. So, we need to just write half CV square. For example, we want to write for C1. So, half C1 multiplied by this potential difference ka square. So, we can take it as VC minus VD ka square and so on. So, we can write these values. U1 half CV square, so half C1 VC minus VD ka square. Half C2 VG minus VC ka square. And so, half CV square for each capacitor. And because we have potential for each terminal, so we have these values. Therefore, adding all these values, we are getting 13/8 C0 E0 square. Are you getting this point? It is very, very simple. These are the values. You can very well write it. Okay. And how this VC minus VD is coming E0 by 4 only? Because we know VC, we know VD, E4 is given to us, 4E0. Similarly, all values are given to us. Placing these values, we are getting VC minus VD as E0 by 4 and so on. So, we are getting this value. Dear students, remember these lines. Sare jahan se achha, Hindustan hamara. Remember these lines when you win the gold medal. Dear students, you must have got your All India rank. Keep working hard to improve your All India rank. The next revision problem will come in next 24 hours. Follow the complete video chain to get a grip over what exactly IIT professors want. Happy learning, dear students.